Students, Sairam, this is Megha Miss here, and today we are going to do revision part 1 of our lesson number 2, periodic classification of elements. Okay students, this chapter also you have for your exam. So just we will have a recap, revision of what we have studied so far in this chapter. Okay students, so we started with the classification of elements. You know students, there is a periodic table in which all the elements are arranged properly, and that we are using it now. Okay, but before that table, what was the condition, where were the elements placed, that we will see. Okay, so today 118 elements are known to the scientific world. More and more number of elements were discovered along with their properties in course of time. As I told you that the modern periodic table is the now which we are using, right? But before there was not that table. Okay, so scientists studied this large elements as previous. Okay, only elements were divided. Okay, as previously only the elements were divided as metals and non-metals. Okay, but later and another class of elements were discovered that are metalloids. Yes students, at the starting there were only metals and non-metals, but now later on the scientists, they started studying more things they introduced in the periodic table, and they found out this metalloids. Now what are metalloids students? You know that they are showing both the properties of what? Metals as well as non-metals. Okay, so now the first scientist we are going to see, that was Dobberener. Now what Dobberener said, he gave the triads. Yes, he made a group of three elements each having similar chemical properties and called them as triads. Okay students, he arranged the three elements in triads in an increasing order of their atomic mass. Okay, he considered the atomic mass and arranged these three elements in the increasing order of their atomic mass. Okay, and showed that the atomic mass of the middle element was approximately equal to the mean of the atomic masses of the other two elements. So what he said in the triad, what he said, he showed that the atomic mass of the middle element, okay, that is the second one, was approximately equal to the addition of the atomic masses. Yes, and their mean was taken, and the whatever value they got was the same, okay, to the second one. However, all the known elements could not be classified into the Dobberener's triad. We cannot apply it for all the elements. So, his theory was not accepted. Okay, we'll just see an example. Here you can see magnesium, 24.3 atomic mass, calcium and strontium is given. Okay, now their mean atomic masses of Mg and strontium, when you do first and the third one, if you see the mean, it is 55.95. Okay, which is not approximately equal to the atomic mass of the middle element, that is calcium, 40.1 it is. Yes, therefore it does not form a Dobberener's triads. Okay students, so like this here a table is also given in your textbook. In that lithium, sodium and potassium is taken. When you add the atomic masses of lithium and potassium, you get it equal to the sodium. Okay, so I hope you can study that also from your textbook. Go through, I took one example where you saw the limitations of the Dobberener's triad. Okay, that was magnesium, calcium and strontium I took. Okay, but they did not follow the Dobberener's triad rule. Okay students, now we will see the next one. Now came the scientist, his name was Newland. Okay, now what did Newland give? He gave the law of octaves. Okay, now the in year 1866 Newland arranged the elements known at that time in an increasing order of their atomic masses. Again he did the same. Okay, it started with the lightest element, hydrogen, and ended up to thorium. Okay, he found that every 8th element had the properties similar to the first. Okay, for example, sodium is the 8th element from lithium and both have similar properties. Also, magnesium shows similarity to beryllium and chlorine shows similarity with fluorine. Newland compared this similarity with the octaves in music. You have Saregama Padhanisa, right? He called the similarity observed in the 8th and the 1st element as the law of octaves. Okay, so see, You have sa re ga ma. You can see the musical note. Sa re ga ma pa dha ni. And again back you come to sa. Right? So like that how you have in the musical notes. He said that elements also. The first and the eighth element show the similar properties. Okay student. So what he said. He told that yes. So we can arrange the elements in the order of the law of octaves. Okay student. This was the table he gave. Okay, I hope you understood till here. Okay, so every first, okay, element will be having, like if you take fluorine and chlorine, okay, you can see, then fluorine and chlorine will be showing the similar properties. Okay, like this he told that whatever the elements will be arranged, they will be showing the similarity. The first and the eighth element will be having the similar properties. Okay, we'll proceed. Now, what were the limitations? This could not happen. There were some limitations again. We will see. This law was applicable only up to calcium. So, only up to calcium, you can see that the first and the eighth element had some similar properties. Okay. Newland fitted all the known elements in a table of 7 into 8, that is 56 boxes. He had only 56 boxes. Okay. He placed two elements each in same box to accommodate all the known elements in the table. For example, cobalt and nickel. What he did in one box, he kept two elements. Can we keep it like that? Now the modern periodic table, what you see? Do you see the two elements in one box? No. Okay. He placed some elements with different properties under the same note of octaves. Like that also he did. Okay. For example, he placed the metals cobalt and nickel under the note Do along with the halogens, while iron having similarities with them was away with the non-metals oxygen and sulfur under the note T. So it happened that some had the similarities, but they were placed somewhere else only. So like this it happened in his table. Okay, no provision was for the newly discovered elements in the table. No provision means no boxes were kept empty for the elements if they get discovered later on. Okay students, I hope till here it is clear to you. Yes, we saw the two scientists, Dobberener, he gave the triads, and Newland, he tried to arrange the elements in the form of the musical notes, okay? And he saw that the first element had the similar properties to the eighth, but this was not applicable to all the elements. Okay, students, I hope till here it is clear. Yes, we'll move forward. Now came the new scientist, that is Mendeleev. Yes, and he gave a periodic table. Now the Russian scientist, Dmitri Mendeleev, okay, developed the periodic table of elements during the period 1869 to 1872 AD. Mendeleev's periodic table is the most important step in the classification of the elements. So Mendeleev was the person whose classification was very important for this modern periodic table. Okay, students. So, Mendeleev considered the fundamental property of the elements, namely the atomic mass, as standard and arranged 63 elements known in that time in an increasing order of their atomic masses. He also at the starting considered the atomic masses of the elements and tried to arrange the 63 elements which were known at that time. Okay. Then he transferred this into the periodic table of the elements in accordance with the physical and the chemical properties of these elements. Now before, if you see, both of the scientists, they considered only chemical properties and they tried to arrange. But Mendeleev, he took in accordance both the physical as well as the chemical properties. He organized the periodic table on the basis of the chemical and physical properties of the elements. He considered both. Okay. These were the molecular formula. He considered what, students? Molecular formula of hydrides and oxides of the elements like magnesium oxides and all, what is formed. He saw melting points, he saw boiling points and densities of the elements and their hydrides and oxides. So he took into the consideration many of the things, many of the properties, and then he tried to arrange the elements. Okay. Now, Mendeleev found that the elements with similar physical and chemical properties repeat after a definite interval. Okay. On the basis of this finding, Mendeleev stated the following periodic law. Now, this is the Mendeleev's periodic law. What he said? properties of the element are the periodic function of their atomic masses. Okay, means after a particular period, the properties of the elements, they are coming similar. Okay, then the vertical columns in his table are called as groups, while the horizontal rows, he called them as the periods. Okay, so from here only he started with the groups and the periods. Okay, students. So again, I'll tell you what was the Mendeleev's. Here important is the Mendeleev's periodic law. What is the Mendeleev's periodic law, students? Properties of the elements are the periodic functions of their atomic masses. So here he considered the atomic masses, he considered the physical and chemical properties, and he saw that after an interval of time, you see that these properties are repeating. Okay, students, I hope till here it is clear. Yes, we'll move to the next part. Now the merits of the Mendeleev's periodic table we'll see. Now the atomic masses of some elements were revised, means he changed, he studied them again, so as to give them proper place in the periodic table in accordance with their properties. Okay, for example, the previously determined atomic mass of beryllium, 14.09, was changed to the correct value as 9.4, and the beryllium was placed before boron. Okay, so he made more and more study and he saw that atomic masses are also wrong, so he corrected them and then he tried to place the elements in the correct order. Okay, Mendeleev kept vacant places in the periodic table for the elements not discovered till then. Yes, he placed some empty boxes also. Yes, which Newland cannot do. Okay, three of these unknown elements were given the names. Now that time three were discovered. Okay, what were the names given to them? Eka boron, eka aluminium, and eka silicon. Okay, from the known neighbors and their atomic masses were indicated, means he tried to find with the help of the neighboring elements, he tried to find its atomic masses also, and it came to 44, 68 and 72 respectively. Not only this, their properties were also predicted by him. Okay, later on these elements were discovered and named as scandium, gallium and germanium respectively. The properties of these elements matched well with the predicted what was predicted by Mendeleev. Due to this success, all were convinced about the importance of Mendeleev's periodic table, and this method of classification of elements was accepted immediately. So whatever study the Mendeleev did, it was so superb, I'll say that. Yes, all over the world they had to accept his periodic table for this study, for the reference. Okay, there was no place reserved for the noble gases in Mendeleev's periodic table. However, when noble gases such as helium, neon and argon were discovered towards the end of the 19th century, Mendeleev created a zero group. Now at the starting, he didn't reserve a space for the noble gases. You know what are noble gases? They are stable electrons, right? Stable electrons they have. They do not take part in the chemical reaction so easily. So what he did, but then also what he did, he prepared created one group, that is zero group, without disturbing the original periodic table in which the noble gases were also fitted very well. So without disturbing his table, what he created before, he made one zero group and kept all the noble gases in them. Okay, students, I hope till here merits is clear to you. Okay, now the next part we will see, that is the demerits. Now what are the demerits of this Mendeleev's periodic table? The whole number atomic mass of the elements cobalt and nickel is the same. Okay, if you see the whole number. Okay, therefore there was an ambiguity regarding their sequence in Mendeleev's periodic table. Now whatever the atomic mass of the two elements are similar, then how we will place them? Okay, in the increasing or decreasing order cannot be possible. So that was one of the demerit. Second was, isotopes were discovered long time after Mendeleev put forth the periodic table. As the isotopes have the same chemical properties but different atomic masses, a challenge was posted in placing them in the Mendeleev's periodic table. Means isotope could not get a place in the Mendeleev's table, in simple words. Okay, then when the elements are arranged in the increasing order of the atomic masses, the rise in the atomic mass does not appear to be uniform. Uniformly, it was not increasing. Okay. It was not possible, therefore, to predict how many elements could be discovered between two heavy elements. So, it cannot, the study cannot be made properly. Okay. Next one is the position of hydrogen. Now, the hydrogen shows similarity with halogens. Yes. Cl2. F2, like that you have H2. Yes, for example, the molecular formula of hydrogen is H2, while the molecular formula of fluorine, chlorine are F2, Cl2 respectively, right? So this F2, Cl2 are all halogens, right? But this halogens and hydrogen, they could not see any connection between the placement of them. Okay, in the same way, there is a similarity in the chemical properties of hydrogen and alkali metals, that is group 1 metals. There is a similarity in the molecular formula of the compounds of hydrogen alkali metals, Na, K, etc. Okay, formed with chlorine and oxygen. On considering the above properties, it cannot be decided whether the correct position of hydrogen is in a group of alkali metals, that is a group 1, or in the group of halogen, that is group 7. Okay, so the hydrogen, where to place that hydrogen, it was again posting a challenge to the Mendeleev's periodic table. Why? Because it was showing so many similarities with so many elements. Okay, I hope till here it is clear. Demerits also you understood. First demerit, you will see that two of the elements, they had same whole number atomic masses, so it became difficult. Then you saw isotopes did not get any place in the table. Then you saw the increasing order of the atomic masses was not in a continuity. So also again it created a problem. And fourth, about the position of the hydrogen. Okay students, I hope till here clear. Yes. So the next came is the modern periodic law. Yes. Now what is this modern periodic law, students? According to the statement, the modern periodic law was stated as follows. The properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic numbers. Yes, student, what the law has been changed to? The properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic numbers. Now, atomic mass is not considered. In the modern periodic law, the atomic numbers is considered. Okay students, I hope till here whatever we revised, you will go through it properly, you will understand it properly. Okay, and we will continue the further part in the revision 2. Okay students, thank you. Sairam.